Hey everybody, welcome to Slash Bash, where today I am bringing you another Choosing Beggar Reddit video. If you are new to the channel, then subscribe and click on notifications so you don't miss out on the fun. In our first story, a Choosing Beggar couch hopper is hard to get rid of, and when she goes, she takes what she can. Let's jump right in. So the house I was living in was a duplex. I was renting out the bottom. My roommate asked if a friend could stay for a couple of weeks until she got on her feet. I'll call her Barb. Barb was living with her boyfriend and they broke up. Now, I know this girl from the bank my roommate and I had worked at previously, so I was fine with it. Oh boy, that was a mistake. Barb reminded me of my younger biological sister, and no, that is not good. Anyway, she was staying there for free, slept on a couch, which I admit wasn't the most comfortable thing, but at least it wasn't the floor, her car, or the sidewalk. My roommate and I both gave Barb money on multiple occasions for gas, as she was also jobless. The position we three all held together was temporary, and the contract had ended. I left before that to a company that I worked at previously, when they offered me a job at $18 an hour. Barb also asked if she could bring her cat. I said that was fine, as it was only temporary. We weren't allowed to have pets, but the landlord never came by unannounced, and he already had been by for the rent. And worst case scenario, we could put it in one of our rooms or the bathroom. So Barb would vanish for a couple days at a time, not a big deal, except she left her cat behind. When she didn't come home the night before, we noticed the cat had no food and no water. I was angry. I messaged her. I so wish I still had the text. Now, this wasn't the first time Barb left her cat for us to care for, except this was the first time she didn't have food. My roommate bought the cat some canned cat food as I talked with her. I told her that it was very rude to expect someone to care for their cat when they were letting her stay in their house rent-free. Had Barb asked, I would have been more than willing, but to assume that we would is downright rude, especially when we have to buy the cat food because you didn't get her cat food. Apparently, Barb messaged my roommate and complained to him that I was being unreasonable, but he was siding with me. She wasn't going to be back for another couple of days. At this point, I told her she needs to get her stuff and leave. Barb arrived at 2 a.m. and got her stuff. She looked pissed off at me. I'm sorry, but I don't tolerate abuse to animals. Yeah, me kicking her out probably made her cat's life more difficult. Anyway, a few days later, I was looking for my Xbox 360, Wii, and PS2. I had them disconnected because I wasn't really playing them, but I had a hankering for some DOA 5 and Mario Kart Wii. They were nowhere to be found. I checked everywhere, tore the place apart. Only one of two people could have taken it. My roommate? Unlikely. Or the girl we had staying with us. The problem was, I'm not sure when it vanished, but there hadn't been anyone else in the house. My roommate found my Xbox account, I hop online, nope, wasn't me. I wasn't playing an Xbox Live game on my PC, though I did have a couple of games like Fable 3. So he messaged it saying, you have my friend's Xbox. No response. I assume she probably sold it to a friend. I was pissed off. The Xbox was the Star Wars Special Edition, R2D2 console that did the beeps and boops, and a C-3PO controller, plus all of my games were gone. I haven't bought a console since then. In story number two, we have a choosing beggar Karen who wants her sandwiches delivered fast and free. So some backstory. I work at a place that sells sandwiches and we deliver. Today, we were extremely busy during the lunch rush, and as a result, delivery times were a little slow. We were making sandwiches as fast as we could, but there were too many orders. Our in-shop line, the customers who come in and order at the counter, was literally out the door. On top of all that, we were understaffed because two of our employees had quit. Instead of the five-man sandwich-making crew we should have had, It was three people, and one of them was the new guy who started last week. Had to stop and ask what came on every sandwich. Eventually, we just put him on the register so that the other experienced employee and I could focus on making the orders. When it finally slowed down, the last few delivery orders were still on like a 40-minute wait, which isn't even that crazy for delivery. Domino's often takes twice that when it's busy. A lady comes in, and while she doesn't have the "can I speak to your manager" haircut, she is making a face. Anybody in the service industry knows the face. Total Karen. I know it's gonna be some bull right away.
I ordered a delivery for three sandwiches and it never showed up. We're hungry. We've been waiting for an hour.
Perfectly possible. It's been a hectic morning and mistakes happen.
Oh, I'm so sorry about that. Can you give me the name and address on your order?
Karen McFake Name at 5555 Someplace Drive Northwest. I pull up the order and have to really put in effort not to roll my eyes.
I see that you placed the order 27 minutes ago. Our driver left with it 5 minutes ago.
Well, he took too long, and I had to leave work to come get it. You guys weren't answering your phones.
Not true, by the way. If we'd stopped answering phones, the morning wouldn't have been so hectic.
Okay, well, we can make your order here for you now and waive your delivery fee since you came to get it.
What are you going to give me to make this right?
I'm thinking, I said I would give you the food and the delivery fee. What the heck else do you want?
Sorry, I'm not authorized to fully comp any meals.
She huffs and then stands there at the counter while we make her food, which you're not supposed to do since other people come in to order, and we have a designated spot for picking up completed orders, but whatever. I don't say anything. We give her food and she leaves, and I text the driver telling him that he can skip that order and move on to the next one, since she already came and got it. The story should end there, right?
Wrong.
15 minutes later, we get a call asking where the delivery is, and I get their name and address. I was very surprised to hear that it was Karen McFake Name at 5555 Someplace Drive Northwest. I double-checked twice, it was the same name and address. Now at first I thought that maybe someone else had overheard Karen order and came to make a fake complaint and get free food.
Oh, I'm so sorry. There must be some sort of mix-up. I just had a woman come in saying that this was her order, so we made her the food and canceled the delivery.
That was me! You said the delivery driver was on the way! Where is he?
Let me get this straight. You came to pick up the food, and I gave you the money for the delivery back, and gave you the food, but you were still expecting us to deliver it? Again, for free.
Yes! To make up for me having to leave work and get it!
Miss, you didn't have to come and get your food. You chose to. It was already on its way. If you wanted it delivered, you should have waited for the driver.
Karen's no longer screaming now.
Can I speak to your manager?
Oh, you absolute fool. Don't you know?
I am the manager.
Click. Guess she didn't want to talk to the manager, huh? Story number three shows us another choosing beggar at the grocery store. I used to work at a grocery store in my hometown. We had quite a few choosing beggars over the years, because I mean, hashtag retail. But I had one story that really stuck out to me. I was working the cash when an older lady, the choosing beggar, comes up to me.
Hello, did you find...
No, your store is all out of low-fat sour cream. It was a local brand of our sour cream. It's on sale. Could I have a rain check?
1 second, I'll call the grocery department. So I call the grocery department, a process that often takes around 5 to 10 minutes, but is store policy when dealing with rain checks. Because even if an item is on sale and we do not have any in stock, we may still not be able to issue a rain check if the sale is less than a week long. Store policy, etc., etc., etc. All this time that I'm waiting for the grocery to pick up, she's sighing and drumming her fingers and just being a total butt.
Could you hurry the flip up? Jesus, probably barely passed high school working in a grocery store. I mean, I pretty near blew right there. I was in university at the time in a different province. Stuff's expensive. On all my breaks, I came home to make as much money as I could. Grocery guy finally picks up and basically says, we don't have any. We do not stock the low-fat version of that company's sour cream because it does not sell as well as their competitors, and it really doesn't matter. We can't issue a rain check due to the length of the sale. I explain all this to the choosing beggar, but obviously, since she's a Karen, she wants to speak to my supervisor. I call my supervisor over and explain the situation. Thankfully, she takes my side and explains the best we can offer is to substitute the brand she was requesting with a different brand. Which is entirely not our store policy, but I think we were just sick of her at this point. She was causing a bit of a scene. No, I don't want that brand. I want this brand. That brand isn't as good. My husband is a veteran. He served our country. You should have more respect for us. You should special order this product. I want 14 packages, and I want it at the sale price. My supervisor calmly explained that we really can't do that because we don't stock the product and because we can't issue a rain check. Offering a substitution was the best we could do, and even that was not really something we were supposed to do. Choosing Beggar's quote, which I remember as if it was yesterday, "Well, Walmart stocks it, so I'm going to go there and get them to price match. It's such a hassle, but at least I won't have to deal with the blanks at this store." Then go to Walmart. And she left. I assume she went to Walmart. My supervisor was crying. Choosing Beggar had literally broken her. Poor woman. A couple weeks later, my supervisor was transferred to a different store in an assistant role. Apparently, management had gotten a call about not meeting customer satisfaction goals. This has been John from Slash Bash. Thanks for watching. If you've enjoyed the video and want to see more of them, then please hit that subscribe button. We'd love for you to drop a like, share it with your friends, and we will see you in the next one.